But anyway, so she called out, you know, I got this from Chick-fil-A, and then she did the call to Blair on the dare, and Blair says, I wish I could have something from Chick-fil-A, so I made something for Blair, never heard from her. So Blair, if you got it, you should say thank you, young lady, in a video. I'm just kidding. I hope you enjoyed it. I didn't really send it to you to say thank you, but I'm just so motherly that way. Okay. I thought that it did not do anything, but with the bright lights, you can never tell. Okay, so we will go ahead and use this. So let me get a... See, because the way this is laying down, all the big brushes are laying on top of little brushes. So I need a cup. I'm going to go back to the cup next video. Don't like this. Also, I feel like I got a lot of the same brush. I know those don't look the same to you, but to me, they look almost identical except for the one in the middle. Now, you do need different blending brushes, but these all have different numbers. I'm like, come on. Come on, really? Anyway, so I'm just going to use the Morphe M433 for the center color because it is the only true highlighter in there. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to turn this around and actually use this brush, and I'll do it at an angle because I've noticed sometime when I do this, I get to where you can't see. Did I even get any on there? Oh, this is the other thing. Remember, we found there was a lot of fallout. There's a lot of fallout on everything in this world. I'm going to do the inner corner and a wash over the rest of the eye. Even though this is all highlighter, that's okay. Come all the way to the edge. This is not going on smoothly. Do you see how it's not smooth? There's a chunk there, but not there. That's where primer can help, though, in all fairness. It evens everything out. Because this isn't catching on the skin the same everywhere. I'm probably going to do a different lid color, so that's okay. But this definitely has an opalescence to it. Very opal. Do you see what I mean? It's like a white peach pink. Very opal. And I'm going to come down here and just smooth over the eyelid. And then just bring it down. Just smooth it out. Just make sure I brought it down over here all the way too. I'm wearing a white shirt, so that stinks, because if there's fallout, it's going to be very obvious. I am going to, there's so much fallout I'm feeling on my face, y'all. Oh, well. All right, so I'm going to use this E50 Fluff Brush, and we are going to use Myth like I always do, because Myth is the only one that is a true neutral in this whole palette. You also could use this as a bronzer or a blush, which may be why they call it cheek. Because I don't see any way to lift this, and there's not anything underneath this palette. Is there? Nope. So that must be what that is. What? I was just going to put that on my face, y'all. Okay, so I'm going to put this in the crease, going from the crease up to right below the brow that we just did. And this is just going to be my transition wash of color, because we're going to put a darker color in the actual crease. This just makes it easier to have something behind the crease that blends the two colors of whatever you're fixing to do next. That's all this really does. Now, for some people, this would be enough. They wouldn't want to go any darker. They wouldn't want gradients of color. I like depth. So now I'm going to take something a little more pointed. We will use, what will we use? None of those. See, this is just too hard to find everything. There's another big brush covering everything up. Another big brush. Where's my little ones? Where's my little pointy ones? Look at this. Here's two more that look exactly the same. Really and truly, you guys, this is a little weird. With all these brushes from Morphe, they look identical. They are blendy. They are some, they're all tapered. None of them are flat. They're all tapered. I'm sure some of them are a little stiffer than others, I hope, because they're more for blending, but still not easy to find what I was looking for, which was a small tapered blending brush E45 from Sigma. This is my extravaganza, which means it was 24 karat gold or 18 karat gold plate on the ferrule. I don't even know if they still carry extravaganza. But anyway, I am going to, we've already tried this beautiful fairy color. I think we put Trance on my lid, which I might do that again. But I'm going out here to Wings. This is a very bronze color. And I'm going to use that, believe it or not, in my, these are all very frosted, by the way. And I'm literally rolling this tapered blending brush, rolling it to load it. Tapping it off real good because this is going to have fallout, I'm sure. So let's see how this does at giving depth. Now, I'm kind of looking up so that it's catching the brush in the crease. I want it to drag a little bit so it'll pull that color off really good. And then when I get over here, I'm going to twirl little circles without picking up the tip of the brush, which really deposits the color. Then I'm rolling, I don't know if you can see how I'm rolling the brush like that to get the color off all ends, and I'm doing that on the outer area. We'll blend that out. I know that's overdone. It's on purpose. See the difference, how this one's more depth than that one? You could just leave it that for daytime. I do this for daytime because I like depth. I like something dark.